Get me out. Get me out. Get me out. Get me out. Get me out.
Here at Highwood High, we are running a party program, prevent alcohol-related trauma in youth scenario. And we use, behind my shoulder here, we used a vehicle donated by Fortis Alberta and our local emergency services, our fire department, EMS, our funeral home, police officers. We used all our emergency first responders to come and provide an example to our students at Highwood High and Notre Dame Collegiate, our grade 9 students, into what an accident looks like in terms of the damage done to a vehicle and what it looks like for us to work an accident. What it looks like for the fire department to pull apart a vehicle to be able to extract the injured. What it looks like for police to be in and around the accident scene gathering evidence. What it looks like for the EMS to be tending to these, to the injured and, you know, to the deceased. We also had STARS on scene today to provide information on their contributions to accident scenes, what they need to think about as they're approaching an accident scene and landing a helicopter. What we want our kids to take away from this is an education about how their decisions, whether it's to drive distracted, whether it's to drive impaired by drug or alcohol, how those decisions, when they get behind the wheel of a vehicle, can affect them through injury or death to themselves, injury or death to the people in their vehicle, or even possibly injury or death to people in other vehicles or pedestrians. How that can affect them and how it's far-reaching, how all of us are affected by poor decisions resulting in motor vehicle collisions.
That wire could be in contact with a fence, it could be in contact with the car itself. And when they, if they're not in any danger at the time, to just stay in place in the vehicle. If there's a fire or such, if they decide that they have no other options, that they need to look around and look at their surroundings, see where that wire is at, and do not come in contact with it. If it's touching the car, to get their body braced, stand on the side of the car, and in one motion leap with both feet away from the car, and then basically hop like a bunny for at least another 20-30 feet away from the car so that they don't come with step potential, which if you just walk away, there's a difference of potential between your front and back foot. So by hopping and keeping your feet together, you eliminate most of the step potential.
It was super eye-opening. because it was like, I was dying. I had a brain injury. I had a broken femur, right? Like those were my injuries. And it took them that long to get me out, which was the, like they were working their fastest and they did incredible and stuff, but it's still like, that's a long time for someone in so much pain and who's unconscious. And so it was super eye-opening to know like all the work that goes into just getting people out of the car.
It just gives you a sort of an idea of all the risk and all the work involved in taking care of the situation. You always hear about the dangers of it, but as you really experience firsthand, you have absolutely no idea of what it looks like. And so we've now been given a rare firsthand glimpse at what it could feel like.
I don't text and drive anyway, but I have a 45-minute drive to and from school every day, and just like on rural roads, and like how long it took them when they were already here and they were already like set up and ready to go on the scene, like how long it would be if I was out by my house like waiting for emergency crews to get there. That was really humbling and eye-opening, and it kind of like brings you down to ground, and I hope that that's a message that we portrayed really well.
Well, my accident was March 9, 2008, which is 8 years ago, and I was 16 years old at the time. And what got me the most about the mock accident was the fact that I was that girl 8 years ago. I was that girl in the back, except I was flown 50 feet out the back windshield. And everything after, when they come out and said her injuries and how she was affected by it, and that was pretty much word for word exactly everything that I had gone through, and losing my spleen and my pancreas, and two-thirds of my pancreas, and the 6 fractures in my spine. I'm hoping that the students will definitely think twice before getting into a vehicle with an impaired driver, or even think twice about, you know, the consequences that'll happen when they go out drinking with their friends. Being able to know that they can call their parents, as much as their parents don't want them to drink, that they can call their parents, that their parents will be there for them. Because I know that was one of the things in my crash, is that my parents would have come and get me if I would have just called them. STARS was the biggest impact to me, because they came in, they flown to the accident scene, had and picked me up and transferred me to Foothills in such a timely fashion as well, where I was able, even last year, I was able to go and meet my STARS team and thank them for giving me my new beginning. And in my new beginning, I have 2 diplomas. I was able to have my 6-year-old son, and now I live my life to the fullest, and it's all because of them, because they got there and they saved me. They saved my life.